Hey guys, welcome back to Campbell Workshop. Today we're going to make a classic tulip. Do you remember our tulip tutorial from the beginning of this year? I've decided to redesign the structure so it can maintain its shape. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for our weekly tutorials. If you like what we're doing, you can also join our not-so-secretive community on Patreon. Link in description. First of all, we need to cut the petals out of the 90g yellow crepe paper. The method is really similar to leaf making. We will need to follow the V grains to construct the petals. Cut a piece of 26 gauge wire in about 10cm. Add some new glue to the middle line. And place the wire in the middle. Place the second half of the petal on top. Add some more glue on top if necessary. Cut according to a template. A paperclip will be very helpful here. We will need 6 petals per flower head. Take a piece of rectangular paper in the height of the template. Then we move on to colouring. We're going to colour them in a bright orange. Colour the petals from the middle and going outwards. Leave a yellow edge. Remember to colour the petals by following the grains. It will be easier to get into the creases. Do the same to the rectangular strips and let them dry. Once the petal has dried, color the other side. Take the rectangular strip out and cut the seam line out of its template. We will need 2 pieces per petal. Trim them if necessary. Attach the seam line to the middle of the petal with some yoo-hoo glue. Place the seam line to hide where the wire is. It can also strengthen the structure. Although everything is pretty much coloured, I will give a final touch around the seam line to fill in some pixels. Next, shaping. Bend the wire in the middle. Curl the sides to the middle and use your thumb as your guideline. You might have a sore thumb if you make too many in one go. Thank you. are going to make the flower center. Pick 3 pieces of 22 gauge wires. Wrap the top 5 cm tube with a piece of 180 gram yellow crepe paper with UV glue. Bend a loop on the top with a round nose pliers. Tape the 3 wires together with the loops facing outwards. Wrap them together with a piece of yellow paper. Cut the 26 gauge wire into about 6 to 7 cm long for the pollens. Cut a thin strip of purple crepe paper and wrap 2/3 of the wires. Bend 1 cm to one side and fold 0.5 cm to the other side, so you will end up with this T shape. Cut a strip of 1.2 cm purple paper and trim them into small rectangles. Attach the tiny rectangles to the tip and fold it over. Make 5 to 6 pieces of them per flower. Use a pair of scissors to trim the tips, and they are ready. Now we can wrap everything together with a strip of green paper. Distribute the pollens evenly around the flower center. Wrap the stem to the bottom. Adjust the pollens so they are standing straight. It should look like this. Now we can put the flower together. Wrap 3 petals to the flower center as the first layer. Alter the other 3 petals as the second layer. Wrap the whole stem with the green crepe paper. Trim the stem if you prefer, because each petal embedded with a wire, so the petals are very adjustable. You can also have an open flower to a budding flower based on your mood. You can play around it. Next, we will make a few green leaves to go with it. Cut the half leaves according to a template. I've also embedded a 22 gauge wire into the leaf for an easy shaping leaf. Trim its shape and expand the leaf a little. Wrap the stem with a strip of green crepe paper and they're ready to decorate the flowers. And we are done. Thank you for watching the video, and I hope you will like it. If you like it, please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to our channel. It will really help our channel to grow. Stay tuned for our weekly tutorials. And all of our DIY kits and templates are available on our website. Check them out. See you guys next week.